I want to welcome a fabulous gentleman who is a wealth of knowledge here. His name is Troy Kemp. He's from the National Center for the Development of Boys. So nice to have you here on the show. Thank you.
Thank you for having me.
We want to talk about the mind of boys, an inside look at what boys need now from the trusted adults in their lives. And we're not just talking about parents, but we're talking about teachers and coaches and what have you. So when we're talking about a boy's mind, how do we, as those trusted adults, end up misreading or mislabeling them?
Well, I think the first thing is to understand that what boys need in terms of their brain development. The male brain is wired to be more spatial mechanical than verbal and emotive. And so one of the things that happens oftentimes is we interpret that they're not interested, they're disengaged, when it's honestly the instructions that we give them. We often don't include enough diagrams, or we don't model. We just will say things, use your words. So when someone says, "What were you thinking?" oftentimes the boys will say, "I don't know."
Nothing.
I don't know. Or they just kind of freeze because they pause. And it doesn't mean they may not have been thinking. It might have been a plan A that didn't have a plan B to follow. But oftentimes, that's just the male brain maturing. And so there's strategies that we can employ that will allow us to get better results and be less frustrated.
So it's all about the approach.
Yes.
And really learning how to speak their language,
yes,
understand what their language is. So what do boys need from us now?
What boys need, the number one thing they need is for parents to be well-versed in terms of the male brain, how long it takes for the male brain to develop. You're looking at almost the age 30 when you're talking about fully maturing male brain, and often we launch these kids off to college and life at 18, mm-hmm, and I tell them, I say, that's like a cake that's half-baked. I mean, I'm saying
they're walking around with half a brain.
Literally.
Literally.
But what they need is for us to model, for first of all, males in their lives, to model certain behaviors, particularly the social, emotional, to show them how to love people, mm-hmm, and love themselves, but also to have people that have a little more patience, but also think about the playbook that we're using to raise them. Mm-hmm. If I want my son to clean the room, I need to show him how to clean the room. The other thing is, I want to use a clock because they're so competitive. Why not use that competitive instinct to your advantage? So I always tell people, never give them 30 minutes, give them 29, and you'll have better results.
Sometimes when I'm asking my son to take something upstairs, I say, okay, I'll time you.
That's right.
Then
that's
it
right.
becomes a challenge.
See, you're an expert right there. You call that a citizen
scientist.
Not yet.
It's trial and error.
Yes.
But what do they wish we knew about them?
Well, here's the first thing I tell people all the time. This is a great question to ask your son. What do you like, but you pretend not to like? Because there's a lot of posture and there's a lot of masks that these young men wear because they're trying to figure out what it means to be a man, but also trying to figure out who they are in the process. So I think it's important for them to let their guard down while you're walking and talking with them. That's the first question that I think is very important for them to know. The other thing is that they'd rather be participants than spectators. Mm-hmm. So anytime you can get them involved hands-on with activities in the classroom or at home, that's important. The other thing is to include them in the recipe for success. Mm-hmm. We often administer our advice like Robitussin, right? Whether you're sick or not, you're going to take this.
Exactly.
But I think it's important for them to give them some choices at times within the choices that you approve. So if you want your son, boys are always hot, so they don't like to wear pants when it's sort of sunny. Mm-hmm. And so he said, son, you're wearing pants today. It's like they're going to argue about it, or choose three pair of pants and say, how about you choose the pair you want to wear out of the three? So it's that kind of thing.
Giving them more choices.
Yeah, I call it Tai Chi and less Kung Fu.
I like that.
Much as parents.
Yeah. Well, I want to tell people that you are going to be speaking tonight. It's a very informative town hall. It's called SOS, Turning Distress into Success. It's taking place tonight from 6 to 8 at Desert Vista High School. We really want to see so many parents out there, educators,
absolutely,
coaches, as you were talking about. And this is free.
Yeah, and I think it's very important because, boys often, well, students in general, but boys will internalize everything. They will not process verbally with much, and they will not talk to people. Oftentimes, I told a mom last night, she says, my son doesn't say anything. He doesn't talk at all. And I said, that's amazing, because when I was a dean of admission at Macaulay for years, parents would say the same thing. And I'd sit in a room with a boy, and he'd talk for an hour with me.
Yeah.
So sometimes it's just, if you're not a threat, they tend to talk more. So I think this evening is more about people really knowing what resources are available, because that's probably the best thing that a parent can do is to find out what resources,
yes,
are available and make sure that they're on your top of your list. And if you don't know, the National Center for the Development of Boys is one, because that's part of what we're trying to do.
You are a great resource. It's understandingboys.org. Thank you, Troy Kemp,
Thank
for being
you so
here.
Much.
You are
Thank
a wealth
you.
Of knowledge, as I mentioned.
Thank you
for being here.
Thank
we'll
you.
Be right back.